Well, welcome to the Allen Performing Arts Center here in Allen High School. On stage before you is the Allen High School Wind Ensemble, and I'm their director, Dr. Philip Obato, and we are so glad to be performing for live audiences. This is what it's about. It's about making music and making passionate, soulful music and sharing it with an audience. So thank you for being here. Normally don't really talk before we start playing, but if you notice on your program, we're only doing one tune. And I do want to say that it's in three movements, and the total time of the work is 30 minutes. It is a symphony for band. But I guarantee you, you will enjoy this tune. This tune, isn't that cute? You're going to enjoy this work, because this has sort of been a labor of love the past. I was just telling them in the warm-up room that I've been looking at this score since the middle of last semester, and we started working on it in January. So for me, this journey is that time. Do you guys watch that show, Tidying Up? It's that time where we look at the score, we touch the score after this performance and say thank you. But we're excited about performing this for you. We've been also very fortunate this week to have a guest artist, a world-class artist with us, the composer Weindark Sea, and a few pieces that you've heard today, and I'm going to ask John to come up and talk a little bit about the piece, but we've had him for since Sunday, and what a great 3 days it's been. So everyone, please give a warm round of applause for Mr. John Mackey.
This is a big one. It's called Weindark Sea, and the commission came from the University of Texas for the 100th anniversary of their School of Music. They wanted a great big piece. And I said, great, but then I didn't know what to do. And I did the smart thing, which is I asked my wife to solve my problems for me. And I said, what do I do? And she said, why don't you base it on, it's supposed to be a big epic piece. Why don't you base it on the original epic story of the Odyssey by Homer, several thousand years old. And I said, that sounds awesome. I've never read the Odyssey. And she said, I'll read it for you and tell you what it says. So she did. And what she did is she wrote, basically you don't have a copy of it, but she wrote me the program note for the piece. And then I wrote the music to go with her program note. So I totally just cheated all the hard work. It's in three movements. For those of you who don't know the general story, Odysseus has commanded the armies that have won the Trojan War, and he is feeling incredibly confident to the point of arrogance, and is bragging to everybody about how amazing he is, how he's as brilliant and powerful and smart as the gods. And the gods get word of him saying these things, Zeus in particular, and Zeus, with his lightning bolts, sinks all of Odysseus' ships as they're trying to get home, and he kills everybody except Odysseus. And that's what happens in the first movement. So the first one's called Hubris, and it's just a big, like, arrogant march followed by this storm, and then everybody is going to die. That's the first movement. The second movement is what happens is Odysseus is, again, the only survivor of this shipwreck, and he washes ashore on this island that's completely deserted except for one goddess named Calypso. And Calypso has been banished to live all of eternity alone on this island. And as far as she knows, she will be forever alone until she finds Odysseus' near-death body on her beach. And she takes him home and nurses him back to health and falls in love with him. And they spend 7 years together. And after 7 years, he says, by the way, I never loved you. And I have an actual wife. And I'd like to leave now and go see her. Because he's the biggest jerk in the world, and she is heartbroken, but she makes him a sail, and the next morning presents him with a raft and a sail and food so that he can leave and leave her alone for all of eternity. So that's the second movement. But then the third movement happens, and Odysseus eventually gets together another round of sailors, and they're sailing on this a new fleet of ships, and they manage to sail foolishly to the edge of the world where it's always night. And then they get this idea that they're going to slit the throats of some sacrificial animals, the blood flows into the ground, and the spirits of the dead rise up. That's the third movement. But that one's actually fast and exciting and fun, and what eventually happens is they do escape from this island, and eventually we'll see in the distance home. They finally, at the end of the symphony, make it home. And you know that happens because, you'll know it happens, because you'll hear something go, oh, I know that tune. That means we're almost done. So I hope you, this, by the way, this piece has been played a lot, but not by high school bands. Like I said, it was written for the University of Texas's Wind Ensemble, which is mostly graduate students in that group. This piece is ridiculously hard. I don't think I've ever been in a performance of the complete symphony by a single high school band. So this is, he's like, I haven't played it yet. the rehearsals these past couple days have been just astonishing. This is way beyond what any high school should be able to do. The fact that they can do this is really just unreal. So, well, I don't know what you're putting in the water now, but it's pretty impressive. So please enjoy Weindorksee.
Thank you. Thank you.